Hey guys, Rick Kerr and the Scaly Dad here with two of my favorite species in the world. First, Pierce.
Really? Not cool.
Yeah, but seriously, we're here with we have a great opportunity to show you a real cool animal, and that is the American alligator. Now, what's really cool about the American alligator is you actually have to have a permit to own one of these. You can't just go out in the Everglades and pluck one up, put it in your pocket, and take it home.
I'm sorry.
You're going to have to give this one back.
Uh-oh.
But seriously, the reason for it is because it's a protected animal here in the United States. And Luke is a great example of why they're protected. Tell them a little bit about the story of what happened with Luke, Pierce.
Well, Luke was owned by somebody who didn't really know how to care for him. They were given a sheet on a... Oh, he's tripping to me. They were giving a sheet about an alligator lizard, and they cared for him like such, but they had him in a desert habitat and were feeding him greens, when this guy needs to be on fresh water and he eats fish. You love me, don't you? And so he didn't really eat as well as he should have. But now, wow, you're just vocal, aren't you? But now he's getting fed what he needs to be, and he's a little bit behind in his growth, but he will start to beef up and get really big.
That's cool. Now, interesting thing about Luke is, just like Pierce said, this is about a 5-year-old alligator, and what's interesting is he should be about this big, because an alligator grows about a foot a year for the first 4 years of life, and then after that they grow a little bit more slowly. So when you see these alligators that are like 14, 15 foot long at the zoos
and
aquariums,
old.
They're pretty old alligators. A couple of really cool things about Luke too to notice is, first of all, his eyes and his nostrils are set on top of his head almost. Tell us why that might be, Pierce.
Well, that is because these guys are perfectly adapted for life in the water. Every single thing about them makes it for optimal swimming and living inside of lakes and ponds. As you can tell by the eyes and the nose on top of the head, is because when they sink down in the mud, they will be able to see and breathe. Now, one thing that is interesting that Luke can do is this. When I flip him over, everything in his body slows down to an incredibly low rate.
That is amazing,
isn't
it?
He's not dead. And it's alive!
It's really interesting because alligators aren't supposed to be on their back. So when he's on his back, his body doesn't know quite what to do. So it shuts down. Now, a really, really cool thing to point out, two things here actually, is number one, he's got a really cool camouflage pattern on the back. If you looked at him, he almost looks like light hitting the water. And on the underside, as Pierce showed you just a minute ago, it's white. And that's so that if things are under him that might be an enemy, they can see upward and see light. And on top, it looks like the water. And the last really cool thing is these little things on his back are called scutes, and they spread the heat all over his body and help Luke to regulate his heat, because like all reptiles, he's exothermic. So for more information about cool animals, stay tuned to scalyadventures.com. We'll see you there.
Wait, that's my line usually.
Oh, I'm sorry.